name is Marlo. I'm your server today. How's everybody doing?
I'm great.
Hey, this is awesome. Come on.
We broke up and it's been hard. I guess it's just kind of hard for me to not talk that way now, like in the day.
dating world. I'm sorry.
I mean, it's not totally you. I mean, I'm on a crap website. I've been on a dating for 6 years. So it was, I don't know.
I was your first date in 6 years?
Yeah.
Okay. That's all. Okay. Thank you for letting me know that.
Is there anything else you want to tell me? Why was it bad for me?
Oh, we don't have to do this.
No.
Okay. Well, if I'm being honest, you were a little distant.
Yeah, that's fair.
Like when I was telling you about my high school football league, you were just kind of like looking into the distance and peeling your acrylics off one by one in the middle of the table. And I don't know. It just kind of seemed like in that moment you weren't really listening to me.
Well, no, I was listening. You were so close to that championship game. Probably should have eaten at that restaurant before, though. I mean, I wipe my nails when I'm comfortable. And really,
you could have told me that. I don't know.
Yeah.
I asked you about your siblings, and you were like, yep. That's not an answer.
I didn't want to bore you with the details.
It's not boring. It's your life. I'm trying to connect with you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I have 4 siblings.
4 siblings?
Yeah.
Any brothers?
All 3.
I have a brother too. Older brother.
Yeah.
Yeah. He actually went to Juilliard for music.
Wow. You didn't mention that.
I did.
Oh.
Isn't it, like, I don't know, like, I just feel like you weren't really talking to me then.
It's definitely my fault. Maybe it wasn't as bad as I thought it was.
Okay. Yeah. It's great. It's coming. I'll see ya.
Doors closing. Doors closing.
What?
make me say stuff like that.
I'm not trying to make you say anything, but maybe I just like the way that my card feels pressed against your card.
You have a way with words.
Yeah. And maybe I respect the way that you take care of your body by the organic rutabaga in your card.
Maybe I respect the self-confidence of having the grocery store cart only full of TV dinners. And one apple.
I give you credit for your observation skills.
Maybe I don't want to go around. Maybe you and I could just stay here.
Maybe I just get lost in your eyes and see an endless waterfall.
Maybe the world doesn't move so fast for me.
Maybe nothing else exists, matters while we're in this frozen food aisle.
Maybe this is what it's like to be truly loved.
Maybe I've been waiting for this moment my entire life.
Maybe you and I could just walk down the grocery store aisle together, side by side. That night was not alive anymore.
Hey, guys,
I never did it.
life, then are we even living life at all?
And that's what New York's all about, my man!
Think that maybe the Statue of Liberty doesn't actually represent liberty at all, given how problematic and corrupt and violent American history.
That's a tough one, Phil.
I think about that.
You know, they say we're a melting pot, but do we all get all equal opportunities? Like, no, hell no. Like, what are we talking about?
You mean you're poor, you're tired, you're huddled, weary. Yearning for free bread.
That's exactly right.
That's exactly.
Does it really?
Yeah.
Like, you know, I lived in New York my entire life. I've
never
been
in the same poem. There's a poem in the
world. There is a poem.
But when you live in New York, you're on the
top.
Right?
Let me tell you.
Cheers!
Cheers!
Oh, me?
Excuse me. Again, mango.
What is going on at this company? Boobies, pussy. Does HR really know about this?
What is the deal, Johnny? Just don't know our acronyms.
Who's training you guys?
Oh, Boobies is the Bureau for Underwriters of Business Intelligence. I mean, it's who our sales force targets to help reach our sales goals, and they did an awesome job reaching out to them this quarter. That's why we're here.
How are we supposed to memorize all these acronyms? They have some kind of training class or something?
I just don't get it. That hot RSM Jason, he reached out to me because he wanted me to give him some oral before he gave me.
That was
the
snacks.
Oh man, gross.
Okay.
Yeah, I was more than happy to do that for him.
Next time you need to let me know, because I'm only married with three kids, but I love you, Jason.
What is this Jason and what is with oral Jason?
Okay, we've gone over this like four times. I don't know how you're not catching on.
I'm uncomfortable.
It's the original adapted allocation list. He uses it so we can compare it to last year's and everyone gets what they deserve.
I'd like to give this Jason a little something he deserves.
Okay. Not around here.
I got him, hon.
Guys need to be a little more, secure in yourselves.
Alright. I think I'm starting to understand how things work around here. Come on, honey, let's go home. I'm gonna give you some dick.
I'm so embarrassed. What are you thinking?
It's a direct investment conversation. You've been making all these bonuses at work, which means more money for us, which means higher taxes. I'm just trying to fit in.
Hey, gang. HR just told me that I need to cut back on the use of TLAs and FLAs.
TLAs? FLAs?
What? Yeah, three-letter acronyms, four-letter acronyms. I guess, next year's activity won't be able to be abbreviated.
What is it?
Thanks for asking. The Financial Underwriter Challenge. Key measurement evaluation.
Fuck me!
Please don't make me go to that. It's gonna be so bad.
why. I tell people I'm busy, I know that they miss me, but life is better on TV. I tell people I'm busy, and you miss me, but life is better on TV. I know there's more to life than Frasier, for the office. But how can anyone stand potential awkwardness?
You look like you want.
Hi, what's your name?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, nice to meet you, Elizabeth. I'm Marlo.
Nice to meet you,
Marlo. Elizabeth, are you having a fun night tonight?
So far, so good.
So far, so good. Only downhill. Elizabeth, do you have any fun plans this week? Anything you're excited about?
Sleeping in.
Alright, well, this is going to be a really awkward question. Elizabeth, do you think maybe, just like one night, I could sleep in with you?
Totally platonic.
Just like, for like
sure.
One day.
Sure. Alright.
Weird, man. thank you, Elizabeth. Yeah, Fred. I'd love to. But unfortunately, I'm like super fucking busy, so. I tell people I'm busy, I know that they miss me, but life is better than TV. I tell Elizabeth I'm busy, I know that they miss me, but life is better than TV. I tell people I'm busy, I know that they miss me, but life is better than TV. I tell people I'm busy, I know that they miss me, but life is better.
That's actually how she got the HPV. anxiety. Know anyone who has it, personally.
Well, you have it now. I'm assuming. I don't know what you guys do.
We do stuff, for sure.
Okay.
That's just, you know,
you're right.
Now that you mention that,
yeah.
Cynthia absolutely told me that.
Yeah.
Because we've had sex, and she would tell me something
that's,
like that
yeah.
before we did that.
You know, she was really worried if it was going to affect her ability to have kids after the 3 pregnancies she had earlier.
Oh.
Yeah. All those pregnancies.
Yeah.
But
I knew about.
She doesn't have a kid.
Yeah, I knew that! I knew that one! And the same way I knew all of everything that you're saying.
Cows. Speaking of cows, she actually went to prison for a life security fraud involving a farming conglomerate.
Yeah.
When she was 16.
Yeah.
I think she should be vacation slides from that.
Well, they didn't really allow cameras in the prison. She drew them. She's a great artist.
Now that we're talking,
yeah.
Is there anything else that I obviously would know about Cynthia? Just obvious things that, you know, that I, her fiance of 3 years, would know. Let's both say them out loud.
Yeah.
I mean, because things that we're both aware of.
Technically, she is still married. But only in Kansas.
To Stephen Curry?
No.
That impressive.
That's pretty impressive. Sounds like you don't really know your fiance that well.
Well, at least she's got a great pussy.
What? Tell us about the wedding. Tell me about the wedding.
It was actually did it in Peru, on top of the mountain, so very exclusive.
Oh, no, I might have chosen Cabo that time of year, but oh, that was nice.
Thank you for that.
Yeah.
You know, I was there, so I was so honored to be, you know, there. Unfortunately, Karen, I met you afterwards.
You would have loved it, Karen.
Here are those waters, please.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, get those menus.
Yeah, can I get a straw, please? My teeth are so sensitive, you know, the ice gets in the way.
Yeah, you know.
Here are those menus.
There you go. Thank you.
The straw, please, too.
The service is so good here.
Yeah, you know, he has very specific wants. You know, that's it. That's why she needs that straw.
Oh, you know, sensitive teeth.
Okay, here's that straw.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Is the vegetable soup vegetarian?
Yeah, so it's vegetable soup.
Yes, but is it made with a chicken broth or a beef broth? I'm also gluten-free and non-GMO. Could you please ask the chef, or do you want me to ask the chef?
That won't be necessary. No check.
So did you have a lot of people on the way? What was your dress like?
Well, like we said, it was just close friends and family. Yeah, the dress was great. It was custom tailored. The one downfall was all the flies.
Oh, I hate flies.
Oh, see, Karen sure does, huh? Like, this one time, I was walking around with the fly swatter. I was flying away. Someone let the window open. It was that Michael Mandel character.
Does have a beef base, so sorry about that.
Yeah, see, just because it's vegetable soup doesn't mean it's vegetarian.
Yep.
Well, I'll get the chicken bacon ranch quesadillas. Thank you so much.
I'll crab ragoons with just extra ragoons.
Chili's great.
So I'll have 3 baby back ribs.
No, he's gonna have the grilled chicken, but with mustard, no ketchup. There's too much sugar in the ketchup. We all have to fit in our wedding garb when we get there.
Thank you, honey. Yes. Yes.
And I'm gonna have the Greek salad, but no onions, no olives, no anchovies, and no bell peppers. And dressing on the side. Take some lettuce. No, but also cucumbers and tomatoes, feta cheese. And pepper cheese.
So I got a Greek salad with tomato, cucumber, and lettuce, and pepper cheese and feta and dressing on the side.
Yeah, do you want me to write that down for you?
I just wrote it.
Okay.
So the quesadillas. We got the ragoon, and then we got the grilled chicken. All right, I'll be right back.
You're doing a wonderful job.
Oh, thanks. So you got some good stories about you guys and Miguel in college. I bet you got some doozies.
Oh, please don't.
Miguel was a big man on campus.
I was.
He used to play the bagpipes. And one time at a show, he forgot his bagpipes, and he used regular cigar pipes for the entire performance.
Well, people do say you're a blowhard.
Yeah, he knows too.
Yeah. Shh, don't talk about our sex life.
Okay. So here are those quesadillas, and we got the ragu, and we got the salad, and we got the grilled chicken.
Thank you.
There's croutons on my salad! I said I was gluten-free, now my face is gonna explode! And there's bell peppers on here, and they're the red kind! You know, they disguise themselves like tomatoes, and then you don't even realize that you swallow them, and then my whole esophagus is gonna be screaming at me all afternoon! I'm gonna take a picture of this for my Yelp review. I think we need to ask for the manager if you can't get this right.
That won't be necessary. I am so sorry about that. No, there are just like so many modifications. I wonder why they got confused. But I'll be sure to take that off the menu, your order, and dinner's in the house.
You don't have to do that. You're just trying to make a living. It's okay.
Thanks, guys.
We did 20%.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
You know, she's not. She's just bossy, and she really knows what she wants. Yeah, that's true. Good? How was it?
Yeah, really. You know, when you get married and you're thinking about changing your name, just make sure you don't change your first name, okay, Karen?
Like Michael Flatley.
I'm not doing this.
It's very much work. This is very special. We need to enrich your senses. 2,000 years ago, a butterfly was born. Through this butterfly, it made more butterflies, which made a rainstorm, which happened earlier today, right before you got here. And I had arranged for this perfectly bright rainbow.
Oh my god, I'm glowing.
Yes.
I've never felt better.
You haven't glowed like this since your first pregnancy.
You are illuminating.
That was a compliment.
The aura is 8 feet long. Senses, and some of these may make you do things that you are not quite compelled to do. However, the treatment will bring it out of you. We have here, from the Himalayas, 1,000 rabid bats.
What the hell is happening here?
Hey, why did you stop it?
You're really being tortured. Do you not see the difference?
Well, yeah, no, it's awful, but I don't know, everything that was happening to you was so nice. I don't know, usually I just kind of leave with stuff like this, and it looked like you're really enjoying yourself.
That's so nice. I wasn't enjoying myself.
I'm bleeding from so many parts
of my
face.
We're going to go to the hospital and get a real doctor after
this. Honestly, I don't know the last time that I felt disconnected to you.
You stuck it out for me. You haven't done that in years.
It reminds me of like, remember the big game?
Well, we met your college soccer match.
It started raining, and I was dead in the middle of the pitch.
Yeah, right.
It's true, Sarah. I'm not joking.
Oh, you guys are pulling a big old prank on Sarah. Trying to tell me that textbooks and storybooks are different. They're books. I know what books are. They're made up.
No. I have never been more serious than this.
Yeah, we are. Very serious.
For real?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, we got it. You knew about this?
Yeah, I knew it was real.
Yeah, she knew Hitler was real. Yeah.
You all?
Waters, right?
Yes.
So
So that makes everything legal, like the Purge.
The
Purge is a law.
I'm legally not allowed to talk about a non-Disney property.
Well, Goofy says that somebody stole his hat. He's lying. He probably lost it, Goofy motherfucker.
Dear children, dear. He's a little calm.
Just
some Disney magic.
He's still
hypothetical.
There might be some more Disney magic on the way.
I'll go find some.
Okay. Goodbye, Pudumatakin. Pudumatakin is so great.
Amber, California shopping. Wow. Have you had a sermon? No matter. That life was. In fact, has California. Going down.
See what I tell you? We got a psychic from California to tell us that, and not from Florida.
Wow. So why do you think you should get a vote?
How
do you
think? My service. Very handy on a flight.
Well, that's an answer.
Oh, hi, I'm Jay Vanderson. Has anyone seen my mom? She said she was going to a fantasy suite with Captain Jack Sparrow to watch Pinocchio's Nose Grow.
Then we will look for your mother. I'm sure she's around here somewhere. That is very concerning. So why do you think you should get a lifeboat, little boy? Use your imagination.
Because I'm the youngest one here, and I have the greatest chance of procreating.
That sounds like a sound garden.
Excuse me. Hello. My name is Red Crash, and I live at the bottom of the boat. In between the barrels of frozen Mickey Mouse-shaped waffles and that weird two-month-old carton of cucumbers.
We have only fresh ingredients.
I do not want to see on the lifeboat. Because I've been living here for 5.5 years, and according to Florida state law, I have squatter's rights on this Disney cruise ship, and if you let it go down to the bottom of the ocean, I will sue you for taking me out of the house.
There's so many questions I have.
Let's sue Disney! Let's sue Disney! Squatter's rights! Squatter's rights! God, I'm going back to this.
Love that imagination!
I'm so sorry I'm white. I'm bigger star on stage. It's great made from white. Oh!
Real star!
Welcome to my honor, yes. You may know me from my role as Timon from Lion King.
From the Addams Family.
Sure. I just want to say I've contributed so much to the Disney project. And I'm just wondering if perhaps I could take that last spot over my phone.
Nathan, wait, this is all
Captain Robbie. Okay, the room.